Hey everyone, Mr. Happy here, and welcome back to A Realm Reborn Revamped. In patch 5.3, they made sweeping changes to patch 2.0 through 2.55's main scenario progression to make it so it was a much smoother experience for new players. Without cutting out any story directly, they trimmed back on quests and cut some quests from the game overall, while adding experience points and updated rewards to the dungeons and quests themselves. Now, I'm playing through it to see just how different it is, how much less time it will take, and this is the second video in that series. Now, if you want to check out the first video, that'll have all the rules and stipulations that we were under, even if we will reference them slightly in this video. Also, we played through the pre-nerf quests a few months ago, and that series, A Realm Reborn Restart, also has a playlist, so be sure to go check that out as well. So for this video, we are checking out the first 24 hours. What did I get done in the first day of playing A Realm Reborn collectively? Now, I will say that this video is not really the first 24 exactly. We're technically going to be looking at the first 26 hours, but I do know where I was at the 24-hour mark and will reference it a few times in this video. Now, in that first 26 hours, we actually got up to the final two quests of 2.0, which is basically two back-to-back dungeons. We're done with all of our job quests up to and through level 50, and are just waiting for the queues on Castrum and Praetorium. Now, several hours before that, we were on the level 46 quests, and we were also just barely under level 47, which we will talk about in a minute here. Now, as a comparison, in my original playthrough a few months ago, we didn't hit this point until around the 36-hour mark, so roughly 10 hours has been shaved off of our previous playthrough thus far. Now, that sounds like video complete, right? But there is something pretty important that I need to discuss. So I said that at around the 24-hour mark, we had gotten to just before level 47 and we were on level 46 main scenario quests. And up to that point, we had done no side content. We didn't unlock or complete Halatali, the Sunken Temple of Karn, Cutter's Cry, or Darkhold. At this point, however, we did become level blocked by the main scenario. Level blocked meaning you need to raise your character's level before you can accept the next main scenario quest. Really, we could have been blocked at 45. I just barely got to 46 by a few thousand EXP, and I don't doubt that I picked that up somewhere along the way. But either way, we did indeed get level blocked while avoiding side content entirely. Now we were able to get around that pretty quick. You know, we did some challenge logs, a leveling roulette, and two Ormveil runs, and that got us to 49, and that was in fact enough to pretty much get us to 50 with the few main scenario quests that were left. Now, I was a little upset, not really, because with how much we avoided doing, it really, really could have happened earlier. This is a far cry from the way that it would have worked in the main scenario months ago, and it is a testament to just how much EXP they added to this. On top of that, our gear was constantly staying up to date, the first time bonuses from completing dungeons, the updated gear rewards from some of the quests. On top of that, our job quests at 45 and 50 were already really good for gear before they actually made these changes. So realistically, one of the most core pieces of advice that almost any veteran gives to a new player completely circumvents the problem that I had with being level blocked. If you're doing the blue exclamation mark quests, which are quests that unlock new features, new dungeons, anything along those lines, or even just doing a daily leveling roulette, you won't fall behind on EXP at any point, and quite frankly, you'll probably be much further ahead than I ever was, even when I had a near 10 level lead at some point. And another reminder, I really avoided a lot of quality of life in order to slow this run down or push it to its absolute limit. Gotta remember, I didn't join an FC for an EXP buff. We weren't on a preferred world. We would have been 50 by like level 35 or something if I was on a preferred world. So if you're on a preferred world, ignore this section entirely. It's just look at how much time was actually saved. And oh man, imagine if I had done those things then instead of rushing them all on the back end. I probably could have been on Castrum and Praetorium even earlier if you think about it. And speaking of the time saved, I mean, don't forget, I barely used any teleports. Now that I'm level 50, I know like around how many teleports I actually ended up using. So remember, we had a free destination and a return spot, but we otherwise only used them maybe once or twice before I was level 45. At level 45, I used them to complete my job quest, and from 47 to 50, when I was trying to get around and get that last little bit of EXP, I also used them as well. But I'd say I maybe teleported like 12 to 15 times at max across this entire, I guess, area of the main scenario. And I ended up with like 180,000 gil, and I could have sped this up by another several hours just by not walking places. So realistically, if you're teleporting places, you're gonna shed even more time off the top. And because I actually use teleports more in the first playthrough, even if I did generally try to avoid them. Now, the next part is really the most important part, the post-Realm Reborn main scenario quest, and they trimmed a lot off the top here. So that's going to be what the next part is about, looking at patch the end of 2.0, I suppose, and going into 2.1 and 2.2 most likely. But man, I'm really impressed with what they did. I guess the only other thing to talk about would be like the individual quest changes, but quite frankly, there was a point where I kind of hit a trance, where everything was going so fast, I couldn't even really identify entirely what was gone, because it just felt like right, I suppose. To give you an example, when I ended day two, I was just before Hawk Manor. When I finished day three, 7 hours later, I went from quests before unlocking Hawk Manor to after you defeat Garuda, which is at level 44. So I got from the level 27, 28 MSQ to the 44 MSQ in 7 hours. That's insane. And that is a testament to just how much they trimmed. Quests that were removed outright were few and far between, but quests that were trimmed down were very, very plentiful. And I still think they could have trimmed out more. I had the same feeling, especially going through Korthus, like, really, they left this way? And I had that same feeling the first time, but the fact that they trimmed so many other things that it just never felt like a drag. They really did a good job with this. And the fact that in a day, with watching every cutscene, we got this much progress is nutty. And I'm really, really happy to see how they've actually landed things. And now we just got to judge the back half on those post-Realm Reborn quests. With that, I don't really have much more to add. Do those blue exclamation mark quests and you won't ever be level locked. Besides, the dungeons will give you bonus gear, which will help you for leveling up. You can do things like your Grand Company hunting log, or even just your Grand Company ranks in general. And even just doing those little things on the side, stuff you'll probably do later anyway, would definitely keep you even further ahead than you really need to be. That's not what the point of the test was. We're trying to keep it as close as possible to what we did before. But that's it. I gotta end the video or I'm gonna ramble on. So thank you everyone for watching part two of A Realm Reborn Revamped. Be sure to like, favorite, subscribe, and share. And stay tuned for us covering the post A Realm Reborn quest in the next video or two. I will see all of you in the next one. And until then, take care.